Today we will begin from page 34, that is the topic of reps and the later topics. We will have a discussion of this page only. Page number 34 we will refer to in today's class. Any doubt from yesterday's class or anything you have, any doubt from the structure of lava, you can raise a question. Else no, I sir. Will not share the screen. Okay, then I am just opening the book. Just hold on. So here the book, you may be able to see. I will start there.
This book is visible to everyone now, I think so.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
I will change the direction. Yes, 1 minute. Sir. Okay, so we will continue then. Chapter number 4 is the topic that we are going through. Yesterday we have seen this structure of flower, 4 whorls of the flower that are floral parts of floral structure. Yesterday we have seen, and then we talked about complete and incomplete flower, then essential and non-essential parts of the flower. In that, some separate topics were there about the perianth, the types of perianth also we learned. Let us now come to today's topic without spending any more time. So the today's topic, that is a part or continuation of yesterday's part only. Another type or another part is there of the flower that is called as bracts. Now, what are these bracts? These are special kind of flower. These are only what? Flowers only. But some special kind of flowers that depends on its position where it is arising. So, what these bracts are, before explanation, I want to you to observe these two photographs or diagrams. So, this photo, if you see here, you can observe where it is placed. This particular flower is arising in a different manner apart from the normally. Normally, flowers are coming on the branches of the plant, that is on the stalk or the pedicel. Yesterday, we have seen stalk kya hota hai, that is the part which connects the flower and the remaining branch or the stem. But here, you cannot observe any separate stem. In this particular photo, you cannot observe that. So, this type of flowers are called as bracts. So, let us now read the actual definition. The flower arises in the axil of the leaf. So this is called as a bract. So if the flower is not connected to the plant body through a stalk, normally flower should be joined through a stalk, S-T-A-L-K. I am talking about stalk. Yesterday's class, those who have learned, they may be knowing. So yesterday we seen that stalk, ya fir pedicel is there. But in this case, in this photograph, you can see in your book, there is no stalk that is visible. So flower kahan se start ho raha hai? Flower is coming out from the axil of the leaf. Leaf is having divided into different parts. So axil is what? Axil is the place where the leaf is connected to the plant. So here you can see different leaves. Now these are not green leaves in this particular photograph. As you can see, they are not green leaves. Still, they are all leaf-like structures for that particular plant. What is this example? This example is of bougainvillea. You can see the name is written in the paragraph. This is a flower of bougainvillea. And the pink color part that is surrounding the flower, that is not the flower itself. That are the leaves of this. So as you can read in this reading part, you will come in this paragraph. So example is given, the large and colorful bract of bougainvillea. It is a bract. It is not a leaf. It is not a flower. Exactly. It is a special kind of flower, you can say. That is why it is written colorful bract of bougainvillea. We will not say flower of bougainvillea. It is a bract of, commonly we can say flower, no problem. But in scientific manner, exactly, it is a bract of bougainvillea. And it is mistaken for petal. That is more important. What is that given there? It is mistaken for petal. It is not a petal. Petals are bright colored. And it is also bright colored. As you can observe the color here, it is not green color. Leaves are not there. So it can be mistaken as petals. Flower is exactly in the center. Remaining part that is around this is not flower. But when normal people observe it, when we don't know about bract, then we may say this as a whole. This whole structure itself is a flower, but it is not so. It is a bract. So flower is in the center only. Similarly, on the other diagram, this diagram is given here also, you can see the support and the outline part. That is a green, I think. So this PDF, it is not coming like that. A same diagram only, diagrammatic representation of bougainvillea is given. So in the book, you can see it is also pink color and it is having flowers in the center. So that is how the flower is there. So actual flower is what? It is very small and generally it is cylindrical in shape and is on the inner side, inside or in the central part of the bract it is present. So I hope bract is clear to all. It is a special kind of flower. Where it arises, this position you have to learn, it arises in the axil of the leaf-like structure. It is not exactly leaf, it is a leaf-like structure. What is that leaf-like structure is known as? That leaf-like structure where this flower is coming outside, that structure is called as bract. So these supporting structures which are present outside or surrounding the flower are known as bracts, where this flower is arising. Any doubt in this? Else we will continue to nectaries. No, so let us now move on to the next topic, that is nectaries. This is related to the term that is called as nectar. In most of the flowers, what is there is a special kind of a liquid is produced in the petals of flower. Where in the flower it is? That is in the petals of the flower. That is the bright colored part of the flower. So in these petals, nectar is produced. And this nectar is sweet smelling, sweet fragrant with smell only. So it is a sweet smelling liquid. This liquid is generally sucked by the insects and most common one is butterfly. So butterfly is sitting from one flower to other flower. It is just in search of this sweet smelling liquid that is called as nectar. Also the bees, the honeybees, they also collect this nectar only. From that honey is obtained in the bee hives. So this is nectar only. And different groups of this nectar secreting cells are called as nectaries. Nectar secreting cells means what? The cells where this nectar is produced. Secreting word, if we see the meaning in English language, it is called produced. So there are specialized cells in the petals only where this nectar is produced. So these cells, the nectar secreting cells only are called as nectaries. These are the group of those cells. So separate groups of specialized cells which are producing nectar are called nectaries. And where they are present, as I told, they are in the petals. So exact position is given there, situated at the base of the pistil or on the base of the petals. So that is how you can see now in this diagram also, like this flower is shown. So these are the petals, bright color part of the flower. In these, at the base, at the lower part, it is produced and it is spread. Nectar pure petal mein spread ho jayega, but basically it is produced at the lower part of the petals. So there nectaries are situated. So what are nectaries? I hope it is very clear to everyone. This is the exact definition. Groups of nectar secreting cells are called as nectaries, where they are situated at the base of pistil or on the base of the petals. What is the purpose now? We can ask separate question. What is the purpose of producing nectar? So nectar is produced for cross-pollination. Yesterday I told you in brief also, pollination is one aspect or one function for the petals. Petals are very bright colored. So because of this bright color, two things are there. One is color of the petal. Second is there, that is the sweet smell is there. That just a minute. Sweet smell. So these are the two important factors which are responsible for attraction of insect. Insect flowers get attracted to them. First reason is because of the bright color, they will attract. Second is because of the sweet smell. Sweet smell kahan se aa rahi hai? That is from the nectar it is coming. So because of these two factors, the insects are attracted towards the flower. They will come and sit on, or they will take the nectar. And as in the process of absorbing or taking the nectar from the flower, they will also take some of the pollen grains. Pollen grains are present where? They are present in the center of the plant, for the flower. What are there? Antherium is there. Or antherium ke top mein jo hote hain, anther hote hain. And from that anther, pollen grains are released. So jab insect iske upar, flower ke upar aayega, so it will also sit on this antherium, and on its legs some of the pollen grains will stick. And when that insect will move to another flower, wo pollen grains ek flower se dusre flower mein transfer ho jayenge. As a result, what is happening is pollination, that is leading to the reproduction of the flowers or plants. So this nectar is responsible for doing that only. because of nectar flower will come, other flower will attract, otherwise flower cannot attract any insect. So that is the purpose for this nectar is to be there. They produce nectar and nectar is responsible for cross pollination. So that is all. In the figure 4.3, the actual flower photograph is given. This is the flower of nasturtium. Nasturtium is an example. The pronunciation is nasturtium. So nasturtium is a flower. It is having nectar. Is just an example only they have given. Almost all the sweet smelling flowers all are having nectar. Is one example is given in the book. So this is all about the flowers and various types of their parts that we have learned in this chapter. Basically, the after the structure of flowers, these separate topics or separate facts are there. Separately, you will prepare. First is complete incomplete flower. Second is essential, non-essential parts of the flower. Then next one we have seen yesterday about tepals. What are tepals? So three topics till now. Then tepals or perianths are divided into two types, sepaloid and petaloids. Next, today we have seen that is about the bract. What are bracts? Where they are present? What are their function? All these you have to go through. Next is nectar. Is what is produced is nectar. Then what are these nectars? Exact definition. What is its purpose? And one example of the flower. One example of both you have to learn. Bract example will be bougainvillea, as it is given in the book. Second one is about the nectar. Is its example also you will learn, that is nasturtium flower. So that is all about this first part of the chapter is over. Now we'll move to the topic second, that is sexuality in flowers. So till now, any doubt anyone wants to ask, may ask. Else I will begin the next one, that is sexuality in flowers. Okay, then I hope no doubt is there. So male, female and bisexual flowers. So there are different types of flowers based on sexuality we can classify. What is this? This is generally the classification. How we can classify the flowers based on what? Based on sexuality. So based on that, we can have different types. So as the name is in the topic, it is given male, female and bisexual flowers. So different types of flowers only we are learning based on sexuality. So now if we are learning based on sexuality, then it will deal with what? It will deal with the reproductive organs, the presence or absence of any reproductive organ is there or not. So just a brief idea I will give before explaining this topic, before moving on to reading. So if any flower is male flower, then what it should have? It should have male reproductive part, that is endrisium. So agar kisi flower mein endrisium present hai, if it is there, then it will be called as male reproductive flower. Only endrisium should be there, a female part should not be there. Only the male reproductive part, that is endrisium, is there in one flower, then it is called male flower only. Next one is female, that is gynecium. Gynecium is the female reproductive part or the organ. It is having it is producing ovules, it is having ovaries, stigma, style, all these are there. So if any flower is having only gynecium and not the endrisium, only gynecium is there, then it is called as female one. Thirdly, if single flower is having both the male part as well as the female, same flower is having, then they can be called as bisexual flower. So this is the broad summary of that topic. Now we'll begin here. So what is generally in the case of the male ones? So the anthers are there at the center of the flower. Anthers are at the tip of the male gametes, of the male reproductive organ. So anther, if you remember yesterday's diagram, yes, just for showing you, I will come to this diagram. In this diagram, you can observe. Now it is clear. So in this diagram, you can observe. I will change color because flower is also red. So in this diagram, in the center, these parts are there. Separate parts are there. Many are there. 1, 2, 4 are there. So all these are what? Endrisium. So in this endrisium, now you observe carefully. At the tip, this yellow colored part is what is called as stamen. Its name is stamen, and it is bilobed. Two lobes are there. So that two lobes are of anther. So this yellow color part is called as anther, or its lower most part, this one, this fiber, this thread, this is flower that connected hota hai. That thread-like structure is called as filament. So this is what we are talking about. So just I showed you in the diagram, otherwise you may be simply thinking what we are talking. So now we will be discussing about anther. So anther kya karenge? This anther will produce pollen grains. Let me come there now. Yes, here it is. So anthers of the stamen will produce pollen grains which will form the male cells. Pollen grains kya hote hain? Pollen grains are the male reproductive cells. They are the male reproductive cells and they are responsible to be called as the male gametes. Male gametes bol sakte hain ya fir male reproductive cells bol sakte hain, same thing only. So whenever we speak gametes, it is about reproduction only, the cells involved in reproduction. So these male reproductive cells are produced by anthers. Second part now, the ovary. The ovary of the carpel. Carpel kya hota hai? Carpel yani ki pistil that is present in the center of the flower. So just I will show the diagram also. So in this in the carpel only ovary is there at the base aur uske andar kya produce hote hain? Ovules. Ovule is what? Ovule is the female gamete, or we can say female reproductive cell. Ovule is having the egg cell. Egg cell matlab why female reproductive cell. So two parts you have seen. Anthers. Anther produce the male part or the male reproductive cell called as pollen. Second one is ovary, and ovaries are producing ovule. Or ovule kya hota hai? Ovule ke andar egg cell hota hai, which is the female reproductive cell. So both the male and the female reproductive cells we have seen, we have learned now what are they. Now let us come about the sexuality. So if the flower is having both the stamen and the carpel, stamen se kya produce hoga? Stamen will have anther and anther will produce pollens. So that means male cells will be produced. Second one, carpel is having ovary, or ovary se kya produce hota hai? Egg cell, ya fir hum ovule bhi likh sakte hain. So both the parts, male part yani ki pollen grains and the female part that is egg cell, both the male and the female reproductive cells are produced in the same flower. If it is done, then that particular flower can be called as bisexual flower. Another name is also given, that is called, also it can be called as hermaphrodite flower. Hermaphrodite flower or bisexual flower is same thing. Examples now, like hibiscus flower. Hibiscus ko hum commonly China rose bol dete hain. You would have seen in our region also, it is very common. It is a red color flower with yellow color andraciums. The pollen grains are also very large. They are easily visible. So it is called hibiscus in general language. So next example is rose, lily, then tomato. All these are having bisexual flowers. So these are some examples of bisexual. Next one now, a flower which has only one of these parts, that is only stamen or only carpel. Agar koi ek cheez hai, one flower mein ya to sirf stamen hai, carpel nahi hai. Or opposite we can do, only carpel is there, stamen is not there. Then that particular flower can be called as unisexual flower. Yesterday's topic, now you recall, we talked about complete and incomplete flower. Complete flower kya hote hain? Complete flower are those which are having all the four whorls. Whorls yani ki floral parts. Flower ke four floral structures se parts hote hain. Yesterday's class we have seen. So if all the four whorls are there, it is called complete. Now what we are talking in this definition, we are saying that only the carpel is there ya fir only the stamen is there, yani ki koi ek floral structure absent ho gaya hai. Means out of four, three are present. That means the flower is incomplete. So that is why such kind of flowers, the unisexual flowers, can be called as incomplete flower. We can give this type of question now in true and false. Like a statement will be given, unisexual flowers are incomplete. The answer should be true or false. Unisexual flowers are incomplete. Someone should tell. Unisexual flowers are incomplete. Yes, true. The answer is true. Yes. So unisexual are incomplete. Why is it so? Because one of the floral structure is not present. Either andracium is not present or gynecium is not present. Anyone is absent there. So example now we will see. Example is like papaya and palm. You may be seeing papaya is a fruit. Why we are talking here? Because fruits are also obtained from flowers. First flower will form. After that fruit will come. So don't confuse in this. We'll deal with this in later. How the flower converts into fruit, that will come in the later chapters. In same class you will learn. So papaya and palm, both of these are example of unisexual flower. Also you can use the same in incomplete example also. Next one now, we will move to the male flower. You see, in unisexual case, subtypes bol sakte hain. Unisexual is divided into two parts, male and the female one. It is also having another name that also let us learn. So if a unisexual flower is having only the stamen, agar only stamen hai, to kya hoga? Only anther will be there. And if only anthers are there, then that single flower will be able to produce only the pollen grains. It will not be able to produce the egg cells or the ovules. So that is why such kind of cells are such kind of flowers are called as male flowers, because male flowers are having stamen, जिसमें anther produce anther present होता है और pollen grains use होते हैं. तो stamen word से हमने एक नया term use कर लिया, staminate. I am telling so that you can learn this easily. Staminate कहाँ से बना है? Because of the presence of stamen. So the such kind of flowers are called as staminate flower. Second one, the flower which contain only the carpel. Carpel का दूसरा नाम होता है pistil. And from the pistil we have got the term pistillate. So if pistil is there in a particular flower, only pistil. Now male part will not be there. Only the female reproductive part, that is carpel या फिर pistil present है, then such kind of flower is pistillate flower or female flower. So these are certain kinds of different types of the flower based on the sexuality. Now one special type of flower is there that is generally very rare, but still it is present. So example, we will also learn this type of flowers are called as neuter flower. Aisa flower जिसमें both male and female reproductive organs are lacking. ना तो male reproductive part होगा, ना ही female reproductive part होगा. So such kind of flowers are called as neuter flowers. Such kind of flowers are neuter flowers. Examples now, example is given here. Ray florets of sunflower. So sunflower is such kind of example. So that is a neuter flower. What does it mean? Ray florets of sunflower. So this is pistillate but sterile. Pistillate मतलब क्या हो गया? It is sometimes it may have some pistils. But still, it is sterile. Sterile मतलब those pistils, यानि कि those female reproductive organs, they will not produce any reproductive cells. They will not be able to produce the ovules. तो इसका मतलब हो गया sterile. अगर वो ovule produce करता, तो उसको बोलते fertile. If any cell is producing reproductive cells, it is fertile. If it is not producing, it is called as sterile. So sunflower is pistillate. Sunflower में pistil होता है, female reproductive organ है. But it is sterile. It is not able to produce the female reproductive cells. So this is a neuter flower. How then reproduction will go in sunflower? We will see in the later chapters. It is a long topic. So we will not discuss now in this particular chapter. So all these different types of definitions are there. In the beginning of the chapter, I told many facts are there. You may be observing. Each and every line itself is coming out as a fact. So basically, you have to learn all these facts. This chapter appears very small, but a lot of information is there to learn there. So that is, I hope it is clear now, sexuality in flowers. Based on that, we can classify the flowers. Anyone, any doubt may raise any question there. Then we will learn. 4.2 topic is the next one. Okay, then we'll come to the general description of the floral parts. We'll be doing that. Four parts are there. In today's class, we'll do the first two parts, calyx and corolla. Remaining will continue later on. So first, we'll see about the calyx. Yesterday class, we talked about the floral parts. Four parts are there. Out of those, two are protective, two are essential parts. Protection करने का काम कौन करता है? The protection is given by the calyx and corolla only. Calyx are sepals that are the green leaves. So once again, for a short recap, because we are learning these things in detail, you see here in this diagram, these green leaves at the bottom, these are the sepals. This is what is called as calyx. This is what we are going to learn. So now in this present topic, we are going to learn calyx. And then after that, we learn about the corolla. Now, what is the corolla? Corolla is the flower itself, or we can say the petals of the flower. The bright color part in this diagram, it is given in red color. इसको बोलते हैं corolla. So these two parts we'll do just now, calyx and corolla. Let us now come to the topic. So first we'll learn about calyx. We are going through the description of calyx. So usually there are five sepals. That is a general number given. It is not always fixed, but it is an average. We can say generally there are five. There may be less than five also. There can be more also, but it is an average. Now the sepals, we can classify these types of sepals based on their position, how they are present. If the sepals are free, they are not connected to each other. All the different sepals, they are green leaves only. And if all these leaves are free from each other, they are not joined together at the same point. So then they are called as polysepals. If the sepals are free, then they are called as polysepals. If all of them are fused, then they are called as gamosepals. So these are the two different variations that are coming in the sepals. Now you can see here in the diagram. Now this is polysepals. All the different sepals are going in different directions. So these are the different sepals. All are pointing in different manners. So this is called as polysepals. All are not connected, or we can say all are free from each other. So this is polysepals. Second diagram here in the same B and C part. Now you can see all the sepals are fused or joined together. So we cannot differentiate in this. How many sepals are there? We cannot easily count there. In the second one, although we can count, but in the first one, it is almost impossible to count also. So if all the sepals are fused or joined together, then it is called as gamosepals. So both things should be clear. Polysepals, sepals are free from each other, and gamosepals, sepals are fused or they are joined. So examples now, which flowers it is present? Let us see. You may be observing various flowers, and this type of sepals, different types are observed. So now you know what is their name of the sepal. So one example is given of hibiscus flower only. In the case of hibiscus flower, what is there? It is a special kind of sepal are there. A second series of sepal also arises. Ek sepal honge, uske upar ek aur sepal honge. So two series of sepals are there. So in this case, what is it called? Because two layers are there of the sepals, such kind of sepals are called as epicalyx. उसको कैलिक्स नहीं बोलेंगे, उसको एपिकैलिक्स बोलेंगे, क्योंकि डबल सीरीज हो गई है. नॉर्मली इट इज कैलिक्स ओनली, बट बिकॉज ऑफ द सेकंड सीरीज ऑफ कैलिक्स हैज अराइजन, दैट इज व्हाई इट विल बी कॉल्ड एज एपिकैलिक्स. सो दिस बिकम वन मार्क क्वेश्चन, इंपॉर्टेंट वन. एपिकैलिक्स इज फाउंड इन विच फ्लावर? सो आंसर विल बी हिबिस्कस. अदर वे वी कैन आस्क, विच टाइप ऑफ कैलिक्स इज ऑब्टेंड इन हिबिस्कस? सो आंसर विल बी एपिकैलिक्स, बिकॉज ऑफ द सीरीज ऑफ द सेपल्स दैट इज ऑब्टेंड extra manner here. Next, now what this particular sepal is doing now? Yesterday I told you it is giving protection. When the flower is in bud stage, it is closed inside the sepal, and slowly what will happen? Slowly over a period of the time, the bud will convert into flower, and as the bud is converting into flower, what is happening? The sepals are opening. In the beginning, sepals are closing the flower totally. You cannot see the flower, or the petals are not visible. Sepals only, the outer green color leaves are visible. But slowly, slowly what happens? The petals will come outside, and the sepals will take the lower position. They will form only the base. So when the flower has fully matured, then sepals are not having that much important role. Sepals ka main function protection hota hai, that also is more important in the bud stage. So let us now read. When the flower opens, as the flower is, bud is converting into the flowers. So the flower is opening. That time what may happen? Some of the sepals may fall off, because now their requirement is not there. They are simply present in a flower. They are not having any important function now. So the sepals may also fall off. Also in some flower they persist. Matlab, the sepals separate, okay, they can fall down, or they can remain in the flower only. They will continue there. They will be a part of the flower, but they are not doing anything special now. So that is, sepals may fall off or they may persist. Now, next thing, sepals may be green. Usually they are green only, but in some cases they are brightly colored. This is, if you recall yesterday class, you have learned, if the sepals are brightly colored, what they are called? They are called as petaloid sepal. Agar hum sepal aur petals mein difference nahi nikal sakte, then such kind of sepals are called as petaloid sepals. Yesterday's class, you can recall. Example of this is given as in gulmohar, where these are red in color. Red color sepals are there, usually green hote hain, lekin flower aur sepals mein difference nahi kar pate hain. It is also generally red in gulmohar, if you see that flower. And also the sepal, the petal or sepal dono ek jaise appearance mein honge, we cannot differentiate. Such type it is called as petaloid sepal. Now the last line is about the protection. Already I have told, they protect the young flower bud, and because they are green in color, you can see they are green in color. So because of this green color, they will have chlorophyll, and then they can perform photosynthesis. So these are two functions. First is giving protection. Second is, when they are green in color, only if it is green, then they can perform photosynthesis. like in bull mohar, this flower, it is red in color. So then in this case, it will not do photosynthesis. It is not having chlorophyll. That is why it is red in color. So if it is green in color, then only it can perform photosynthesis. So all the aspects are related to corolla. We will learn in the second part. First, we have learned about calyx. Any doubt, you may raise any question. Else, we will continue then to petals or corolla. Okay, then we will continue. Then this is the last topic of today's class, that is corolla or the petals. These are the bright colored part of the flower. Let us read about this. These are generally arranged in a single word. All the petals are generally present in a single word. Almost all the flowers are like this. We'll see some of the diagrams given on the other page. Right now only we'll see. So most of the flowers, majority of the flowers are having the petals in single word only. But in some cases, what is there? They are complex kind. So there you may observe double word. Also, they may be arranged in a different patterns. So example, you can see here like poppy. This is a flower. The flower is arranged, the petals are arranged in double whorls. I'll try to bring some photographs in the next session in biology. These flowers, by observing the photographs, it will be more better. So next time I will try. Today it is not possible. So poppy flower, it is having double whorls. So it may be possible. So generally single whorl, otherwise some special type of flowers are also there, like water lily. Water lily flower mein kya hota hai? The whorls are arranged in a spiral manner. If you have seen that flower, you may easily recall. So the pattern of arrangement we have learned. Now the types, now types of petals. The petals may also be free. Jaise sepals free hote hain, so they are called polysepals. Ab petals free ho gaye to usko kya bolenge? Polypetals. Term same, term both are same. Bas petals ki baat ho rahi hai, to we will say petals. Sepals mein kya liya tha humne? Sepals we have taught polysepals. So that is only the difference is coming because of the term only. So here polypetals means petals are free, they are not connected to each other. If they are joined, if all the petals are connected to each other, then they are called as gamopetals. So that is, we will see now in the diagram, figure 4.5. you can see new book page 35 it is given. So here you can observe, if it is free, all the petals are free from each other. Yellow color part of this flower, these are petals. Here you can see all are moving in different directions. So there we can say they are what? These are free petals. Because they are free, you can call it as polypetals. So that is what is polypetals. Now the later part in the B and C diagram, you will see in this, you can see petals are there, but they are arranged or fused in a petal in a tubular form. How is it? So you can see closely now in this diagram, the petals are free here. I will change color. The petals are free here, all this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 directions are it is going, but at the base you can see all of them are joined together, and here you can see a tubular structure is there. So at the tip they have become separate, but remaining flower, it is not opened completely. So this is, we can say it is fused in a tubular manner. So because it is still fused, whatever manner, still it will be called as gamopetals, because petals are joined or connected to each other. Here it is not, photograph is not clear, but in the book you can see this is another one photograph given or diagram given about the shape of the petals. So sometimes generally the flowers are of this shape only, that is funnel shape, nothing important, you can leave this. So what is we have learned just now is petals can be free, then they are called as polypetals, or petals may be fused. If they are fused, they are called as gamopetals. So I hope it is clear. Then next one is about the function, the last slide, that is about their function. So what these petals are generally are having the function is because of their colorful and because of the bright colors and the fragrance that is there, they will attract the insect for pollination. So this is the first and also the primary function of the petals, to attract the insect for pollination. Second function that is given here is they can give protection to the stamen and the pistils, especially when the petals form a tube. So second function that is given here is about the protection. They will protect the stamen and the pistil, yani ki reproductive organs, the female and the male part for the reproduction is protected inside it. As you can see in this diagram also, in this at the center, what is there? The reproductive organs are there. So these are in the center only, they are closed inside the surrounding petals, so they can be protected in such manner. So these are the two functions that are given for the corolla. So two things, both of these floral structures we have gone through in details, calyx and corolla. So that is all for today's session. Any doubts still here, you may ask. The remaining chapter will be over in the next week only. And after that, we will come to the revision also. That is about chapter 2. Because chapter 2 live classes have not been till now. So chapter 2 will take after this class. So any doubt today's class?
No, sir.
Okay, then we will have the attendance. Let me come here. 29 students right now. Aditi, Aman, Aman Vase, Anshika, Damini, Devraj, Kanika, Kashish, Keshav, Mayank, Mohammed, Mohammed Salman, Niyati, Ojasvi, Om, Pari, Parth, Pratham, Priyanshu, Samra, Shavar, Shumak, Tejal, Vaibhav, Vanya, Vansh, Vansh Kardwal, and Yashpadil. Okay, that is all for today's class. Your class is screenshot I take for attendance. We have the attendance sheet, you have to maintain there. So that is